comorbidities, the medical problems that we're talking about, are many. The short list of those simply include high blood pressure, coronary artery disease, cancer. Many times people do not realize that almost all the major common cancers are increased in obesity, either double up to 15 times that of healthy weight individuals. And once they lose that weight, that risk goes down. Other problems such as type 2 diabetes, sleep apnea, fertility problems, both in men and women, and also, of course, arthritis, heartburn, reflux, just to name a few. Now, these are medical comorbidities, but there's other comorbidities that are important that are often not discussed. Things like physical comorbidities, such as clothing selection. You can't go out to any store and just buy clothing. The clothing often is limited selection, often more expensive, a much more difficult situation. How about going out to a movie, riding on an airplane, going to a movie theater? Many of our patients become homebound because they feel uncomfortable in those positions. They don't fit in the seats. Personal hygiene and mobility are also important disabilities. We also have to think about social and economic discrimination. Studies have shown clearly that if you're morbidly obese, you're less likely to get the job. If you're morbidly obese, you're less likely to get the promotion. You may even get paid less for the same job, and this often drives morbidly obese patients into a lower socioeconomic group in our society. Other things like schools. Again, studies show that if you're trying to get into college, if you're trying to go to medical school, for instance, or dental school, or architectural school, graduate school, you're less likely to be accepted, even though you may be equally qualified. Associates and friends can discriminate against you, even friends and family. One of the ones that I'm particularly embarrassed about is discrimination of doctors and nurses. Doctors get very frustrated because they often talk to their patients about losing weight. They say, your blood pressure is out of control, your diabetes is out of control. Go back to the home, lose weight, come back next month. You come back, you've done nothing but lose weight. Now they get angry and frustrated with you, when what they're really doing is realizing that they have a little treatment to help you with.